Saint-Gobain, the world leader in construction and high-performance materials, reports results for the full year 2016.
Pierre-André de Chalendar, hello.
Hello.
You are the chairman and CEO of this 352-year-old French-based company. What are some of the highlights of these full-year results?
2016 has been a good year for Saint-Gobain, with steady progress of all our results. Our sales grew organically 2.6%. Our operating income grew organically, like for like, more than 10%. Our recurring net income plus 20%, and our net self-financing plus 29%. So a good set of results. This is the case in all our sectors who grew and improved their profitability. So, in fact, our efforts in terms of innovation, in terms of investments in emerging markets, in terms of operational excellence are paying off. And what I found really good in this year is that this progress have been realized in all our geographical regions. All geographical regions have improved their volumes, and pricing has got better as the year progressed. So, a very good year for Saint-Gobain.
Close to 50% of your profits and two-thirds of your sales come from Europe, countries such as France, Germany, the UK, and the Nordic countries. So what is your outlook for the housing and residential renovation markets there? Is the long-awaited recovery set to take off?
When you look a little more in depth at our result, it is clear that in Europe, the crisis in our markets is behind us. And our very strong European footprint is becoming a growth asset for Saint-Gobain in the future. The recovery will continue in our main country. Despite Brexit, we have a steady performance in the UK and in France, a year of stabilization, but we have seen an improvement in volumes in the last few months, and this should amplify in 2017, despite some uncertainties on the renovation market.
You're a strong player in the U.S., both in construction and industrial markets. Why are the U.S. So important to Saint-Gobain, and what is your outlook for 2017 in the U.S.?
Well, since the acquisitions of Norton, CertainTeed, our main flagship brands in the U.S., Saint-Gobain has been clearly a market leader in its main markets. And the U.S. is important for us. It's around 15% of our sales. We have a strong R&D capability in the U.S., and we intend to grow further. It's a priority for us to improve our footprint even more in the U.S. So we'll be very active on that front.
Beyond the upcoming French presidential election, are you concerned about other political risks elsewhere around the globe, be it, for example, Brexit or another Greek crisis or even a Trump presidency?
You know, we are there are clearly a number of clouds in the political world around the planet. We are used to that. And what I am particularly is important for me is that Saint-Gobain markets, despite all that, should be well-oriented. And so I am optimistic for Saint-Gobain, despite those uncertainties, that we will manage.
What can you tell us about the status of your bid for the Swiss chemicals maker Sika, and what implications might this have for the future of your M&A strategy?
Sika is a very good strategic opportunity for Saint-Gobain. It is an operation which will be good for our shareholders, which will be good for Sika, which is economically sound, and which is perfectly lawful. So it may take a bit more time than what we planned, but we are patient. You know, we are 352 years old, as you said, so we are able to be patient, and we have not paid anything yet. What is important to have in mind is that we are not, in the meantime, standing still. We have been quite active. We've made more than 30 acquisitions this year, either in the field of new territories or to add technological niche to our portfolio, or to consolidate our markets, and we will continue to do that. We have also accelerated the pace of our digital transformation. So Saint-Gobain is marching forward.
And finally, what can we expect from Saint-Gobain for the rest of this year, and what is your path to growth?
Well, growth, you said it. This is our main agenda, and Saint-Gobain will grow in 2017. A few priorities for this year. First, price. The environment has changed. Our raw material and energy are bouncing, price are bouncing back, and we need to increase price. We have a good track record, but we will push that ahead strongly. Second, innovation. That's a strong part of our DNA. And I am very proud that we have once again been nominated among the 100 most innovative companies in the world. So we'll continue to invest in R&D innovation for more differentiation. Third, we will continue to work on cost and operational excellence. We have a program launched last year, and we should generate around 270, that's a goal, million of euro of savings this year, in addition to what we have done last year. And finally, we will continue to prepare for the future. We will continue to invest more, and we have increased our CapEx program to 1.6 billion in terms of industrial automation, modernization of our plants, in terms of digital transformation, and to invest in new countries. And in addition to that, we have a good pipeline of small and medium-sized acquisition that we intend to pursue on an opportunistic basis. So we will stay very active to grow significantly this year.
Pierre-André de Chalendar, Chairman and CEO of Saint-Gobain, thank you very much.
Thank you.